Hello. A couple of months ago, I made a video about scientism. That is the name that I learned at school of a fallacy. That means that you're not doing science, but scientism, something incorrect. You mix up different disciplines. You use concepts of one discipline in another discipline that where those concepts do not belong. For example, the concepts life or metabolism, reproduction do not belong in chemistry or physics. The concept of slavery from human history does not belong in atomic physics. Let me say a few general words about philosophy and knowledge, acquiring knowledge. Human beings are curious. By this I don't mean that humans look or sound curious, although some of them do, but not that the human in general looks or sounds curious, because there is nobody outside and above humans to whom humans look curious. No, I mean in the sense that people are curious about the phenomena that they discover in the world. They want to acquire knowledge. They want to find explanations of phenomena, and that is what we call knowledge. And I think it is scientism if you state that there is another discipline of finding knowledge, of finding explanations for the world. And I find such statements on YouTube. For example, a long time ago, William Lane Craig was talking about supernaturalism. He insisted that there is such discipline, although he did not use exactly these words, but that's the meaning that I got. And he was even trying to find another word for supernaturalism, because he said this term has got a bad reputation. But it is true, according to him. So he suggested extramundialism or something like that. But for him, there did exist another discipline of finding knowledge, and that is supernaturalism. And that is the discipline of religion, the discipline in which they find explanations for the world. And for them, that explanation is that there is a person outside and above humans, human persons, who has created everything. Father Christopher Jameson is another person who is talking about another discipline of finding knowledge. But he expresses it in a different way than I did, with a domain of philosophy and a chunks of this domain being separated from the domain of philosophy and establishing their own domain, the different sciences. He finds another metaphor. If in the middle you have the word mystery, and then arrows which point to that, and with these arrows, what he means is different disciplines through which you can seek for an explanation of some phenomena, which he calls mystery. And yes, when we don't know the explanation of some phenomena, then it is mysterious to us. We don't know what is happening there, and you can call it a mystery. And apart from the arrows, the disciplines of physics, chemistry, biology, he includes another discipline, theology. So he insists that theology is another discipline which can give explanations for the world, for human life, and the physical world around us.
So is religion outdated in the 21st century? At one level, the question answers itself. There are 4 billion religious people in the world. So at one level, of course, religion is not out of date, because there are still so many religious active in the world. So presumably the question is asking, has the great developments in science and reason that came from the 18th century in Europe, has that European Enlightenment developed in such a way that the beliefs of religion are now going to fade away and disappear. So what I'd like to simply offer you is a mental picture that may help the whole discussion. Imagine a circle in which you write the word mystery, and around it are a series of arrows trying to penetrate the mystery. And one arrow will say physics, another will say biology, another will say psychology, and another will say theology. And that we are together trying to understand the mystery of life. Now this goes wrong when one person, as used to be the case historically, when one person puts their science, their ology, in the middle. It used to be theology. But I would say the danger is that if we put another ology there, whether it's biology or physics or whatever at the middle, we will end up with a similar problem.
Now, okay, which disciplines should we consider more profitable for finding knowledge, for finding good explanations about physical phenomena or other phenomena in the world? The disciplines of science are working on the principle of objectivity. That means that nobody's word is taken for granted. Anybody can, in principle, make the same experiment or do the same measuring, and he should reach the same conclusion or the same explanation. That is why science is built on the principle of objectivity. In the opposite way, the disciplines of supernaturalism or theology, which have different names, I think, for one and the same discipline, are based on the principle of subjectivity. Supernaturalism, that is, explanations about a phenomena that may come from the imagination of somebody, maybe from his dream or something like that. And they are based on the principle of subjectivity. If you look, the further you look in the discipline, which I put in inverted commas, of theology, you find always subjectivity, because it is people in the ancient world wrote a book that with an explanation about the world, that God created the universe and people. But this is subjective, because it's people who wrote a book, and through so many centuries this book has been republished, and some people read it now. But it is still based on the principle of subjectivity, and it is always suspect, because, as I said, it may come just from imagination. So yes, looking back through history, we find that there were people in ancient times who thought they found an explanation for the world, and they wrote a book with those explanations. And it is evident that is subjectivity. This is based on the principle of subjectivity. People just say that, because otherwise the books would have been written, I created the universe. How does Genesis start? God created the world. It should say, I created the world, if it was dictated by God. Evidently, people wrote what they thought was the explanation of what they saw around them then. And this is subjectivity. As I said, science is based on the principle of objectivity, the origin of better explanations for the phenomena that we see. I think I will be making more videos with other examples I find in videos on YouTube of scientism. Bye!